us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord. A word from the Lord. Just one word from the Lord.
Yeah. We'll move. We praise you, Lord, as we had an opportunity to worship you this morning. Father, many have gone with heavy hearts, but they came, Father. And I pray, Lord, that you would bless them, Father, for being here. That they may go out and bless others with heavy hearts. And hope and faith will take over mourning and sorrow. Father, we worship you and praise. We worship you, Father, in our giving. And Father, we made this house what you said it should be, which is a house of prayer. Now, Father, we get down to the moment of proclamation, Father. We pray, Father, that we might be doers of the word and not just hearers. We pray, Father, that we might live out this faith. That we would live it out in such a way that it will draw this lost and dying world, Father. This lost and dying community. This lost and dying city. This lost and dying world, Father. We might be the light of the world that you've called us to be. And in so much darkness, we should be shining as the light. And I thank you, Lord, for all of those who have served this community. And may their efforts not go unnoticed, that they may be blessed for serving you. We thank you, Father. And Lord, help us to be doers of your word and not just hearers. In Jesus' name, amen. And praise the Lord. Amen and praise the Lord. Bethlehem. Once again, we want to thank you for being in the house today, and we want to remind you that this is the month of study. This is the month of study, and the practical application that we want you to take starting Monday in this month of study is that we want you to begin to study the Word of God 1 hour a day. For most of us, all we have to do is to sacrifice a television program to be in the Word of God.
All right.
And that's what we are challenging you to do this month and the month of study. And we want to encourage you to read through the book of John.
All right.
Okay. The book of John, because in the book of John, you have a someone with the vantage point of a friend of God. John was a friend of Jesus.
Yes, he was.
And we want you, as you study the word, to pray that God will make you his friend. Amen.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. Because when you study that God would make you his friend, it will begin to take you through this extreme Bible makeover, into which my series this month is entitled. We're going to have an extreme makeover through Bible study. Amen?
Right.
Amen. Amen. Our prayer is that we might be a friend of God.
Yes.
We're also challenging every member that the Word of God will be our standard. And the standard is what we will live by.
All right.
Amen?
Amen.
Yeah. Amen. Now let's go quickly and read our text today. Click that. It's going to be about six times. Would you stand in reverence
the reading of the Word of God, stand symbolically saying that I will stand on the Word of God. One more. And it's two slides. This is Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 5 and 7b through 10. Go back again. Let's read this together on three. One, two. Wait a minute, where's the other one?
go up one and see.
Go up one.
No back.
Okay, go back. Let's see. I mix it up with my dyslexia. Go back. Go down another one. Let's see. Okay, well, read it from your Bibles. Pick up your Bibles. Go back to the other one.
Go back, Melvin.
Yeah, go back to the other one. Okay, read in your Bibles. Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 5, and then skip down to verse 7 through 10. Okay, in your Bibles. Chapter 5, verses.
Chapter 8, verse 5,
and then skip down to 7 through 10. Let's read this together. 1, 2, 3.
And Ezra opened the book in the sight of all the people, for he was above all the people. And when he opened it, all the people stood up.
Also, Jeshua and Sherebiah. Jamming.
Okay. Keep going.
Hojo. I can't say all of them.
And the Levites called the pain.
And the people stood in their place. So they read in the book in the law of God distinctively and gave the sense and caused them to understand the reading.
And Nehemiah, which is the Tershah, and Ezra, the priest, the scribe, and the Levites that taught the people,
said unto all of the people,
this is the day is holy unto the Lord your God. Mourn not, nor be weak, for all the people wept when they heard the words of the law. Then he said unto them, go your way, eat the fat, and drink the sweet, and send portions unto them for whom nothing is prepared. But this day is holy unto our Lord.
Not grieve,
be sorry.
The joy of the Lord is your strength.
Amen. You may be seated in the household of the Lord. If you don't mind, I want to read this over again. Ezra opened the book, and all the people could see him because he was standing above them. And as he opened it, the people all stood up. Then the Levites instructed the people in the law while the people were standing there. They read from the book of the law of God, making it clear and giving meaning so that the people could understand what was being read. Right. Nehemiah, the governor, Ezra, the priests and scribes, and the Levites who were instructing the people said to them all, this day is a sacred day to the Lord your God. Do not mourn or weep. For all the people had been weeping as they listened to the words of the law. Nehemiah said, go and enjoy choice food and sweet drink, and send some to those who have nothing prepared. This day is sacred to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength.
Amen.
From above, we